Hello guys, today we are going to discuss about risks involved in mining operations. We have engineer Bilal Wahid for this useful topic. Let me ask him how much risky these mining operations.
As far as risks are concerned in mining, all the profession know there are a lot of mining risks involved, but specifically I want to discuss and show you a very common phenomenon which often occurs when there is a combination of hot beds and underneath shale beds. So what happens when we cut the quarry, when we make benches and when we cut a specific rock, when there is hard rock and underneath there is a shale bed. So what happens? So when the cut is exposed with shale bed underneath, then that shale bed is a potential danger. How? Because as all know, shale is a weak composition material. So when water is added to it, or there is an inflow of water from any means, then a slush is created underneath. That slush creates voids, because when slush is created, it flows out. What we see, which I have discussed with you, the same phenomenon. There is a black shale bed underneath the hard rock. So what happened with us? That shale already contains water, which we will show from the other side to you. So when it flowed down, it rested, subsided. So obviously the hard rock which was above it, all this took some space. So moment occurred and you can see, the whole bench has collapsed and it is no more workable. So this is a very common phenomenon. So what we have to do? First, we should avoid such type of situations where there is a hard rock and above the shale bed. So we should make cut which should rest upon hard rock. So, but if it has happened, because when we do excavation, we don't know what is underneath. Then what we can do for safety? For safety, you should never rest your machinery over that portion or we at the foot of that benches. So that we can do after we have done excavation. So we will show you where the water which made the all of the bad work which was happened is because of water. So we will see where that water. Now we are exactly under that subsided area. No, this is the water. This is the whole problematic water which caused that actual fall, because that water made the shale material into a mud which flew with the flow of water. So you can see the water here, you can see, and it is still flowing and it increases during rainfall.
And we have created a separate channel side by side with the road for its flow.
So now what is the remedy? The remedy for it is when you preempt that there is water, then the only things which we can do with our resources is simply we should bore drills in feet everywhere so that it should provide bleeder holes. So all the water should flow through it. When the water flows, then it does not create any pressure or slush position. So when it flows, it will find some way to flow and without forming any problematic slush behind. So this is the thing which we can do.
This is the whole area slided. It has been fragmented naturally without any blast, and it has given profit in a sense of material, but it's a potential hazard in safety point of view.
So the problematic water which I was talking about is that you can see clearly, see, it has been thrown and been gathered in that in the pit,
and so it increases during monsoon.
Now from actually flowing to there will be some moist areas.
Stop working.
So Here's another view, which is showing the whole bench, which we previously used for our Now we have to do it, which takes a lot of time, a lot of danger, but we have to do it.